Lying down lesson, it's actually pretty simple. You want to tie one leg up, and then you want to go and put your right on the opposite side. Most of the time I use a full cheek snaffle because it's a mild bit, but it'll also, you know, it's a bit that it'll get to keep their head to the side. So what we do is we put their head to the side like this, and we encourage them to lean the opposite way of their leg that's up. And then I stand on the leg that's upside, and then we gently pull on the saddle and kind of encourage him over. You can also encourage them back, but I don't always like to do that because sometimes they struggle with this leg and you can get kicked with it that way. So I try to stay off to the side and pull this way. That position where they're kneeling, a lot of the times that's whenever they'll try to spring back up because they get scared. They're really this puts them in a very vulnerable position. So they don't like to be vulnerable. And so once they're down and they get rewarded and they can relax and we release the leg, that's whenever they realize, okay, I'm good, I don't have to fight. And you should have seen him today. He's always been really antsy about tying in the past. He'll move around a lot, things like that. It's okay for him to get back up. No, don't roll in the saddle. Don't roll. But today, we saddled him up and he didn't move a muscle. I mean, we brushed him, fly sprayed him, no problem. And he can do all of this, I don't care. I just don't want it to roll on it.
Yay! Good boy, you did it!
So we're gonna do that again. So you just put your lead rope around the hoof, around the ankle part, okay? And then take your rein, fix your saddle.
That's even rolling in it.
I usually don't use my super nice saddles for this because they can get torn up. So if you have like a little lightweight saddle that you don't mind damaging a little bit, typically it doesn't hurt the saddle, but you know, it can happen. So get all of your tack back to where it needs to be. And notice he's calmer after he lied down than before. So he's not worried about the lying down process. It didn't traumatize him. He's actually calmer than he was before. That's the great thing about this whole deal. There we go. Didn't want that to poke him. All right. Good boy. Did you see him pick his foot up? He was like, okay, let's go. I'm ready. So I don't have to worry about it. Put the rein back here, okay? And then bring the head to the side. Them all over. If they're head shy, rub them on their ears. Even if they're not head shy, rub them on their ears. He doesn't like to be poked. So I poke him. You know, just all these things that they don't really like. He has a lot of injuries. I get the feeling that he had a lot of shots, so he doesn't like for you to walk up to him and, you know, mess with him like I have a tendency to do. And then I came and I did it today, and he didn't even react. He was like, okay, who cares? Because yesterday, while he was down, we did that. Oh boy. His little toms. Touch his toms. Touch his butt. No, stay down. Good boy. Touch his little tush. Wiggle his little tail. Standing on them like this. I don't like that. But, you know, to each his own. The other thing he was doing he didn't do today.
What?
The first time that we lunged him, he didn't buck at all.
Huh.
The second and third time, he did. He broke in two. Today, he didn't buck at all during lunging.
Good.
Anything we
We're not being mean. Everything's very relaxed. And he's really relaxed. He's not freaking out. He's not scared.
Good boy.
This is how we got so dirty yesterday.
You see?
Quite a dirty little one.
Except yesterday he was sweaty. Because he was being bad.
Yeah.
During the lunging session. Was just being all the way around feisty yesterday.
Mm-hmm.
And so we were like, okay, time to lay this boy down. So on this other side, we're going to switch and put the rein on this side. And the rein is going to go up and behind the cantle of the saddle. Okay? Again, I stay to the side because if you get up here and he fights, kick that leg out and hurt you. So I like to stay to the side. Now we're going to ask him to flex and get his head on that side, okay? And we're going to put some weight on the saddle. Yesterday I was really tired, so I went over there and I messed with his feet. Because once he got down, he was just like, I'm not getting back up. He was so tired. Because we lunged and lunged. Where you can get on them like this and then get up. I don't usually recommend doing it because I've heard of horses like that. Okay. I've actually heard of horses hurting their back legs that way. But you know, if you have a hard time getting up in the saddle and you have a larger horse compared to your small body size, I don't think it would be a problem for you to mount that way. Especially people with bad knees and things like that. And it's so easy and simple, and it's actually pretty safe. So, and you know me, I'm one for safety. So let's do this side again, because we did the other side twice. I just give a little pressure on the rope. Good boy. Ask for that foot. Just use a simple slip knot, just like you would tie your horse up here. And then pressure on the bit, ask for the giving and the bending. And then just give a little pressure on the saddle. And he's already putting his head down, so he knows what's coming. That's good. That's really good, actually. I'm going to go ahead and let him do that, because eventually we're going to not want to put his foot up. And we want for him to just follow that cue. Wait. That's really good. He's smart. And he's quirky. Oh my gosh, this horse is cute. This horse has had a really hard life, and good. There you go. This is a nice horse. He has had a really rough life. This horse has a lot of reasons to not like people, and yet he still does. And so he's really nice. He's a good boy. With the two ladies that saved him, and he's got a lot of reasons to like people. they're very, very protective, very sweet women. But that doesn't always matter, you know. If a horse decides they're scared, sometimes.
Yeah.
I don't do it very often because it's kind of, you know, it can be time consuming and not really what you're going for that day. You're trying to ride and keep going, but it's worth it. Good boy. Hey, buddy.
Thank you.
reward. They did what I asked them to, so most of the time, however long they want to lay there, I just let them relax.
It's a good boy. You're such a good boy.
Alright, that's it for today. You did great.